I remember when I was a four-year-old kid and my father had taken me to a shoot to watch. He'd gone to meet his friends. And he said, you sit here, I'll just meet my friends and come. And I was sitting in the studio and I thought this was a place that seems the most comfortable to me, more than a school or more than a playground or more than a cousin's house or anywhere in the world. I thought this was the most beautiful place in the world. And I was watching a cabaret being shot. And they kept doing it again and again and again. But what actually I remember most of that evening is when my father told me, sit here and don't move and don't go anywhere. Today, when I look back at it and I realize that 25 years I've been there, and for that matter, the whole life after that, I've been dreaming to be here, and I'm glad I'm stuck here and doing what I have to do. I still, as a child, remember going to a theater and watching that those projectors used to have that beam of light that falls on the screen across. And always, my mind would never be there. My mind would be here and watching those particles float into it and say, one day my story will float, my characters will float, and that's how I want my film to be. All these films that I've made, I think 9 films I've made, and 10th one is the one I'm making. It's been 25 years, and I hope 25 years more. Yes, Heera Mandi was something that my friend Moeen Beg got to me as a 14-page story 14 years ago. And then finally, when we presented it to Netflix and they loved it, they thought it had a great potential to make a mega series. It's very ambitious, it's very big, it's very vast. It tells you of the story of the courtesans pre-independence. They kept music and poetry and dance and the art of living, the politics within the courthouse and how to emerge as the winner. I hope it's a difficult one, but I hope we come across with flying colors this time.